We have yet another story coming out of Florida, and it's a crazy one, but it could turn out to be a good turn of events considering it happened because it was such a tragedy. So in this picture, you see three individuals. I'm gonna start on the right. On the right, you see a man by the name of Joshua Barnes, and on the left, you see two degenerates by the name of Jake Bilotta and Ian McClurg. Jake and Ian were basically both convicted of murdering Jake's ex-roommate, who was Joshua, who was this guy right here, over an alleged theft of a PlayStation and saying that they were killing him as a form of revenge. However, I think it's more to the story than what they claim. And I wouldn't be surprised if Joshua Barnes wasn't even the one who stole this PlayStation. But I'm going to get into it right now. A Florida man was found guilty of stabbing to death a former roommate in what prosecutors described as revenge for stealing his PlayStation. Jake Bilotta, age 26, was convicted by a jury Friday of first degree for the 2018 killing of Joshua Barnes, age 24, in Maitland. Now, look at this. This happened back in 2018, and it took them 4 years to find them guilty. Bilotta received a mandatory life sentence of life in prison without the possibility of parole after the court rejected his self-defense claims. Bilotta's other roommate, Ian McClurg, age 25, testified against him during the trial after pleading guilty in 2020 to accessory after the fact and tampering with evidence. So his own roommate threw him under the bus. Seminole County Sheriff Dennis Lemma previously said that Bilotta and McClure concocted a plan to lure Barnes to their home after suspecting him of stealing a $300 PlayStation 4 game console several days earlier. Bilotta was so quote-unquote aggravated when he found out about the theft, according to Lemma, that he punched a hole in the wall and decided to kill Barnes. When Barnes arrived at the home at his former roommate's invitation, ostensibly to go to a party together, Lemma and Bilotta stabbed him 17 times with a 7-inch chef's knife. "You're killing me," Barnes was quoted by McClurg, who witnessed the stabbing, as yelling out during the deadly attack. According to prosecutors, the plan was for Bilotta and McClurg to place Barnes' body into garbage bags and bury it somewhere, but the plot swiftly unraveled when another roommate returned home from a date and caught them red-handed inside the blood-splattered residence. Bilotta said he had to give the effort credit. He put up a good fight, according to the arrest report obtained by the Post. McClurg was arrested by deputies inside a bathroom. Bilotta fled, but was quickly tracked down by a police helicopter to a parking lot a mile away from the crime scene. During his trial, Bilotta took the stand and testified that Barnes' killing was in self-defense after he allegedly reached for the knife that Bilotta said he had been using to chop up marijuana. "It wasn't supposed to happen," Bilotta told the court, arguing that Barnes overreacted, seeing the knife in his hand and escalating the situation by trying to attack him. Prosecutors said Bilotta's versions of events did not add up and was disputed by witness testimony. They later tweeted that the motive was revenge for theft of a PlayStation, not self-defense, as Bilotta claimed. McClurg is serving a 10-year prison sentence for his role in the murder. This is crazy. That is crazy. And this is the one right here who was pretty much the ringleader. This is the one that was just there, and he got the 10-year sentence. He got the life imprisonment without possibility of parole. Finally, they actually got one right when it comes to a crime such as this. It only took him 4 years to do it, but you know what? This is the outcome. This is the perfect outcome. So if it took the 4 years to come to an outcome like this, so be it. I just don't like when they taking 4 years to come to an outcome that is not logical or lines up with the crime that is committed. He stabbed this guy 17 times. Can you imagine the pain and agony he had to go through? That's like literally a slow death. They said with a 7-inch chef's knife. That's a long blade. I can't even imagine the pain and agony this guy had to go through during that time period. Over an alleged stolen PlayStation 4. And even after doing all of this, they still don't know what happened to your PlayStation 4. Or do they? I wonder if this was a whole plot just to get him over there, just to kill him regardless, and it had nothing to do with a PlayStation 4, because I don't see anything stating about the PlayStation 4 being stolen. Maybe he resented his ex-roommate that much. Maybe he didn't like him that much that he had to come up with a plot, which he did, to eliminate him, which he unfortunately did. Now, what really helped this case along was the other roommate coming home from a date earlier than expected and actually seeing these two standing over or around this man's dead body. And they said it was a blood splattered apartment, because you know, when you get stabbed like that or even shot, the blood splatters. And this guy got stabbed 17 times, so I can only imagine what it looked like in that apartment. It probably looked like a horror movie. But I'm glad that he got exactly what he deserved. In a sense, he did too. But, you know, it is what it is. But this one right here, definitely. And I hope they put him in Gen Pop exactly where he needs to be for the role in which he plays. And maybe what happened to him can happen to him when he gets there, if you know what I mean. I can't believe I'm actually saying this, but Florida actually got one right. Or another one right, because these, you know, in Florida, these happen few and far in between. But then again, this is Florida we're talking about here. No slight to my Florida subscribers, but you know how Florida is. But that's crazy, though. Over a freaking PlayStation 4. That's wild to me. You mean to tell me you just couldn't go out and say get another one if you felt like it was stolen? Sure enough, if you feel like confronting the person that stole it, yeah. But the thing is, he made a wild accusation that this guy stole his PlayStation 4 without even any definitive proof that he did take it. He just assumed that his ex-roommate did it, which means that they were probably having issues before they ended up parting ways as roommates. After all, I mean, he's his ex-roommate. So there was most likely some issues going on there before. They didn't part ways on good terms. And it makes you also wonder if they got into any other altercations before they stopped being roommates. Was it physical altercations? Was it verbal ones? What was it? Was it over the PlayStation 4? And then it makes you wonder, like, the apartment or whatever they were staying at, whose name was on the lease? Or as well, both of their names should be on it. But who did it get left to? Because it sounds to me like it was his apartment. And the way he's making it sound is like he came to the apartment maybe when he wasn't there and took it because maybe he had a key or he just had found a way to get access in there and take it. But again, no definitive proof that Joshua Barnes took the PlayStation. You just assumed that it was him. Well, we don't have to assume who murdered Joshua Barnes. We know who did that. And the person who did that, hopefully they get exactly what's coming to them wherever it is the hell they end up at. Same for him too. He ain't off the hook because he could have stopped it. He was just as a much intricate part to this than he was. Granted, he was the one doing the killing, but he was there. He was an accessory. Both of them are trash and they both should get what they deserve.